about the dance you guys are doing?
Well, we're using a Chinese flavor song, and within that song, there's a rumba rhythm and a foxtrot rhythm at one point. So we're mixing those three elements together. It's going to be a surprise dance.
And Fanny, what have been the challenges so far with getting to learn the dance?
Having a pun. Yeah, this is a musical. It's a music composed by a Chinese musician about a love story, Chinese version, I mean, similar to Romeo and Juliet. It's very beautiful.
David, I'm volunteering on the Dancing with Ritual Stars. I don't know how they qualify me as a star, but in any case, I'm doing my best to try to learn the quick step with Debbie.
Hi, I'm Debbie Wong, and I'm really pleased to be able to help with this fundraiser. And I've got Terry, and he's a real challenge. No, he threw me a real challenge when he came into the ballroom. And the first thing he said was, you have no problem with me as far as stamina goes. I'm very energetic. I want to dance full of exuberance and energy. So I decided to throw a challenge back at him. Okay, I said, let's do the quick step. So that's what we're trying to do right now.
Right. Terry, what's been the biggest challenge for you learning the routine?
I think body awareness. I tend to be a fairly cerebral person. Of what my body is doing has been a real eye-opening experience. Debbie has pointed out to me that my body isn't doing what I think it's doing, and becoming aware of what it actually is doing has certainly widened my perspective on a lot of things in life, just becoming aware of the physical side.
With the City of Richmond, and I am dancing with my professional instructor,
Alexander Cherdansov.
And what dance are you going to be performing on March the 2nd?
We are doing a samba with a few other Latin influences.
Now you have maybe a little bit of an inside edge being a former figure skater, but tell me how that's worked out for you.
Well, skating on ice and dancing on the floor are completely different, I would say. Despite my ability to cut out my foot, even without skates on my feet.
But it helps a lot for ballroom. Karina feels pretty good on hardwood.
So bring us up to date. You've been practicing for how many weeks?
Oh, only about 4 weeks or 3 weeks even. Twice a week. So six times.
And is the routine getting easier and more natural?
Yeah, it really is getting easier and more natural, both. My partner's choreographed it so that it fits with the music really well. So it kind of makes sense when we're doing it as to what comes next. But having said that, I wake up all night long thinking of what comes next in different parts of my dream when I'm dreaming about this. So I don't know how natural it is yet.
What do you think you've been able to develop going through the last 4 weeks as a celebrity dancer?
Well, it's very interesting about how one uses their body. Now, there are times when Zillian will say to me, you know, put your arms straight. And I really think my arm is straight. But it's not until I look in the mirror that I actually realise that my arm is not straight. My arm is not by my ear, where he's asked me to put it. And you start to have a much greater appreciation for how your body works. Because your brain doesn't always replicate what's in the mirror in front of you. It's quite weird.
Mm-hmm. So, with a couple more weeks to go, what are some of the things you have to work on?
I have been told that we have to work on the details now, like the hand positioning and posture and those sorts of things, because we've got the steps right. Now it's just a matter of honing all of that so it looks really sharp in the final competition.